I've just agreed to make a trade with a guy.
Success!
That was only a 2-hour ordeal.
Oh, man.
Got it though.
It's all right, they charge by the hour, it's fine.
You know what, we don't have to worry about getting it off.
I kind of do, but
check it out, guys. Oh man, this has been a long time coming. It's not quite finished, but it feels really, really super close.
Good morning, everybody. It is one of my favorite times of year. It is time for the steam show. Now, if you're not familiar with the steam show, I've covered it several times on the channel here, but it's a fun and somewhat different experience every time. This time is going to be especially different because I have two new pieces of equipment up here to play with, and I got some friends that come up too. I believe you guys probably know Mr. Chris from Let's Dig 18 and Mike from Dirt Perfect YouTube channels. They're going to be joining me as well, and we're going to be hanging out this weekend, checking out some sweet old equipment, and yeah, having a good time, so stay tuned. So right off the bat here, trying to show you guys everything that happened in chronological order, but I kind of jumped all around, so if something doesn't flow or quite make sense in this video, it's my fault. Anyways, at the end of the video on the Lorraine shovel, you guys saw it leave on a low boy. Now, at the other end of that drive was my buddy Mike that helped me get that thing running. He was already up at the show, so I asked him to help me get the thing unloaded so I could finish working on Christine to get it up there in time. So this is him taking it off the trailer and her arriving at her new home. When are you gonna buy one?
You're a bad influence, Matt. I go to Florida, I end up with a haul truck. I come up here and end up with a shovel.
I think your wife would love it parked in the driveway.
You met my wife.
Have you met mine?
This is the ask for forgiveness, not permission scenario.
Yes.
Good. man, Matt's two first buckets with a shovel. I'd have to say he's doing pretty good. I'm impressed.
It is days after the show has ended, and the old Lorraine made it here in time. I barely got to even dig anything with it because I was so busy doing other things, but it's here, it operates, it does everything it's supposed to do. Some things still need a little bit of TLC on it yet, one of them being the radiator. So you guys saw we tried to patch the radiator before. Pressure tested it at the house, all good. Went through the hassle and headache of installing it, and it leaked again. So we're up here, gonna pull it out now, and I'm gonna take it to the radiator shop and let him worry about it. And that way I have a guarantee that it's gonna work again. So I took a lot of drone footage up there a couple days after the show. It's kind of weird. I've never taken any footage when there's nobody there before. It's kind of like a ghost town. It's a very noisy and busy place during show time, but it's strangely relaxing whenever there's nothing going on and you can really study all the equipment. And man, the drone just gives you the perspective of how big this show is. If you've never been to this show, I will leave the details all down in the description, and hopefully I will get to see you there one of these days. Other than that, I think that's the end of this video, guys. I didn't get a whole lot of footage, but the footage I did get, I hope you enjoyed. As always, if you did, hit that thumbs up button. It really helps me out. It doesn't cost you guys anything. And I will see you guys on the next one. Thanks for watching. Later.